Make a date with Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei at 6 a.m. from Monday to Saturday on Graphic Online via Facebook and YouTube as he expounds on matters of faith.
Graphic Online, truth and accuracy every day.
Hello, this is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei of Living Streams International, bringing you matters of faith with Graphic Online. Still on a Christmas roll. Still on a Christmas roll. The story of Christmas, all the nitty-gritty events are filled with revelatory truths for me, and I'm still on it. And one of the things today that I'd like to define today is swaddling confinements. Swaddling confinements. Swaddling confinements. Now, if you read the Bible story very carefully about the wise men's visit to Jesus, the Bible says, now when they got to Bethlehem, they found the baby there wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. Wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And I use the word swaddling confinements with a question mark. Now I'm very interested. The King of Kings, born. Look at the way the wise man is here. Where is he that is born King of the Jews? And there he is, you know, in a manger, wrapped in swaddling clothes. So the picture is very simple. The toes of the feet of the baby was covered. The hands of the baby was covered. The only thing that you see, and I live with an OBGY doctors, you know, and so I know what they do. You know, they've wrapped the baby. The only thing that you can see is just the face. It is just the face. Now, if you look at it, you will see the hands, you will see the feet, you will see the, you just see the face. You know, one of the things that lying in that manger, if people knew, and why would they wrap that? It is for their protection. It is to prevent them from getting an infection or whatever, to get mosquito bites or whatever. They've just wrapped them up there like that. Now for me, I'm excited, because here's the thing. That's the king lying there, but his feet were covered. And so here's the thing. The only picture that God shows to you about people, the picture that God shows about you to people, I'm not necessarily the whole total picture. Sometimes God just shows you just a glimpse. So people may see you, and the only thing they will see is a glimpse. Just a glimpse of your potential. Just a glimpse of what God wants to use you to do. But guess what? Those feet that are covered are going to be walking on water. Those hands that are covered are going to be healing the sick and raising the dead. Those hands are going to be laying their hands on people. Those hands are going to perform miracles, multiply 5 loaves of bread and 3 fish, and feed 5,000 people with that scanty amount of food. Those hands. Can you believe this? And that's exactly what it is. So there are many things about you that people may not see. And because they may not see, they may pass, there's nothing about it. But there are things that God hides about you. There are things that God sometimes wrapped you up in swaddling clothes so that nobody will see. They may not see the hands that will hold, you know, the stethoscope or the scalpel or the surgical knife. I mean, they may not know that money is going to be, that hands are going to be counting monies in abundance that they've never seen before. They don't know that those feet, even though they don't see those feet are going to walk in places of positions of prominence. They're going to walk in corridors of power. All those things at the beginning are hidden. No man's destiny is written upon the forehead of his face. And therefore, sometimes you may not know that the person you are dealing with is wrapped in swaddling clothes. You may not see the hand, you may not see the feet, but don't make a mistake and underrate the person. Why? Because what God has for the person, what is coming with that thing wrapped up there, you have no idea. So here's the thing. Some things about you may not be known. Your potential may not be fully known, not fully investigated by people who know you. But guess what? It is there and it is growing. God covers it. Proverbs 25:2, the Bible says, it is the glory of God to conceal a matter. Sometimes God hides things about you. not for this thing, but not for harming you, but for your own protection. Because there are places you have to be walking. There are things your hands must accomplish, and things your hands must do. And for the moment, but he has to cover it in swaddling clothes. So guess what? Swaddling clothes, protections, yes. But more than that, the purpose is to hide something powerful. So today, if you feel your hands are covered, your feet are covered, don't give up. It's just a matter of time. It's just a matter of time. And so here, take heart and be encouraged that the story of your life is not yet over. See you later.